heaviness and excavation and catharsis and whatever, but I for sure don't have the bandwidth to do that particular kind of work these days. And so I wouldn't want to ask you all to do work that I wouldn't do myself. So I wanted to try something a little more joyful today, where, you know, I really miss my friends. I like miss my friends. I miss my communities. I miss my family. I miss my families. And so much of how I'm thinking about making poems in particular these days is, if it's not an offering to someone or to a group of people that I love, then what am I doing? And you know, that offering can take lots of different forms, but today in particular, I wanted to bring in poems by friends of mine, by people who like are my friends in my head, and just start to think about the ways we honor that particular kind of love, and what kinds of offerings we can make to that particular group of people. So kind of we're looking at love poems today, but you know, love poems about friendship, or about community, whatever capacity you want to engage with that word. And just to, you know, try and bring a little light and a little lightness into the day, because it, you know, it's hard enough as it is. And so I hope that it brings you some lightness, some joy. This workshop is my offering to you all. I hope to like conjure my friends and my loved ones in the space through this workshop. This workshop is an offering to them as well. So yeah, thank you all so much for going on this ride with me. My face is gonna go away, and I am going to pull up, can everyone see that? Okay. So the workshop is called These Are My People. It borrows a line from a Fatimah Asghar poem, which is probably my most quoted poem of all time. And that's going to be the first of the poems that we look at today. So hopefully, this is how we did it last time. It is a little bit like Wild Wild West when it comes to Zoom. So we're just gonna self-govern and figure it out. But could I get, if you could type in the chat box, can I get a volunteer to unmute themselves and read If They Should Come For Us by Fatimah Asghar? Can I see the chat box? Where did it go? Where did it go? Oh no. What is Zoom? How does this work? How do I see the chat box again?
At the bottom in the middle.
Yeah, it's not showing up for me for some reason because I'm sharing. Oh wait, here we go. All right. It just was like off to the side. Can I get Angel to unmute yourself and read If They Should Come For Us, please?
Sure. Hi everyone. If They Should Come For Us by Fatimah Asghar. These are my people, and I find them on the street and shadow through any wild, all wild, my people, my people. A dance of strangers in my blood, the old woman's sari dissolving to wind, bindi a new moon on her forehead. I claim her my kin and sew the star of her to my breast. The toddler dangling from stroller, hair a fountain of dandelion seed. At the bakery, I claim them too. The Sikh uncle at the airport who apologizes for the pat down, the Muslim man who abandons his car at the traffic light, drops to his knees at the call of the azan, and the Muslim man who sips good whiskey at the start of Maghrib, the lone Kala at the park, pairing her kurta with Crocs. My people, I can't be lost when I see you. My compass is brown and gold and blood. My compass, a Muslim teenager, snap back in high tops gracing the subway platform. Mashallah, I claim them all. My country is made in my people's image. If they come for you, they come for me too. In the dead of winter, a flock of aunties step out on the sand, The Dupatas turn to ocean. A colony of uncles grind their palms, and a thousand jasmines bell the air. My people, I follow you like constellations. We hear the glass smashing the street and the nights opening their dark. Our names, this country's wood for the fire. My people, the long years we've survived, the long years yet to come. I see you map my skin, the light, your lantern long ahead, and I follow, I follow.
Thank you so much. So everyone also, I imagine, I hope, brought something to write with and something to write on. Could be notebook paper, it could be your computer, it could be your phone. So before we get to the poem, I'm gonna ask you to make some lists. No one's gonna see them. These are just your notes. It'll all eventually, my hope is, build out into a palette that you can draw from when you sit down to write the actual poem. So the first thing I'd like you to list is three things that come to mind when you read the line, my people, my people. Who to you is my people, my people? So three things. And then the Zoom feature I'm gonna ask you to use, when you're done making your list, is there that thing that happens where you can raise your hand? Oh no, why did I stop sharing? Hold on. One second. Auntie Soft trying to figure out Zoom. Sorry, y'all. Okay, so there should be a thing where you can raise your hand. So when you're done with your list, just raise a hand and it'll show up on the participants list for me to give me a sense of how much time we need. So right now you are listing three things that come to mind when you read the line, my people, my people. Okay, a fair amount of you have your hands up, so we're going to go to the next poem. Can everyone, what is the verb, like unraise their hand so that it can clear the slate for the next round? Thank you. Okay. Next, hold on, this is a two-pager. Can I get a volunteer to read the poem Feet by Ross Gay? You could volunteer in the chat box. Go ahead, Miles.
Friends, mine are ugly feet, the body's common wreckage stuffed into boots. The second toe on the left foot's crooked enough that when a child asks, what's that of it? Left more haywire than the right. I can, without flinch or fear of doubt, lie that a cow stepped on it, which baby makes them fear cows, for which I repent and love, as I am with those philosophical beasts who would never smash my feet, nor sneer at them, the way my mother does. We always thought you bought you good shoes. Honey, she says, you can't blame us for those things and for this and other reasons. I have never indulged in the pleasure of flip-flops, shy or ashamed, digging my toes like 10 tiny ostriches into the sand at the beach with friends. But I'm not sure love me, though. I don't think Tina loved me. She liked me, I think, but said to me as we sat on lawn chairs beside a pool where I lifeguarded and was meticulous at obscuring from you a book or towel, my screwy friends, you have pretty feet, and that gaudy cement mixer, Levitt Town accent that sends all the lemurs scaling my ribcage to see. And she actually had pretty feet. So I took this as a kindness, incomparable, and probably felt a little bit in love with her for that afternoon. With the weird white streak in her hair and her machine gun chatter, and probably her gun snapping, and so slid my feet from beneath my Power Man and Iron Fist comic book and into the sun for which they acted. Like plants opening tiny mouths to the food hurtling to them through the solar system. Like plants, you could watch them almost smile, almost say thank you. You could watch them turn colors and be almost emboldened as much as some snaggered 2 feet can be emboldened. And Tina witnessed none of this because she was probably digging in her purse or talking about the howdy on the railroad or yelling at someone's friend little sister to put her ass in her trunks or pouring the crumb or her Fritos into her drawn open mouth. But do you really think I'm talking to you about my fucking feet? Of course she's dead. Tina was her name of leukemia. So I heard, why else would I try sadly to make music of her unremarkable kindness? I am trying, I think, to forgive myself for something I don't know what, but what I do know is that I love the moment when the poet says, I am trying to do this, or I'm trying to do that. Sometimes it is a horse trick, but sometimes it's a way by which the poet says, I wish I could tell you the truly of the little factory in my head, the smokestacks chuffing, the dandelions, the Persians and willows, sweet clover, prying the blacktop. I wish I could tell you how inside is a steady mumble and clank of machines, but mostly I wish I could tell you of the footsteps I hear more than I ever can ever count, all of whose gates I can discern by listening closely, which promptly disappear after being lost again here, where we started in the factory where loss makes all things beautiful grow.
Thank you so much. So, I keep trying to alternate between 1 and 2 pages. Next, I would like you to list 3 things your friends have taught you to love. So it could be anything of any scale. It could be like literally yourself, or snow crab legs, or polyester, or the collaborations of Ja Rule and Ashanti, or Mandarin oranges, or your own singing voice. You know what I mean? Or. So of those many, many things, I'd like you to list 3, and then raise your hand when you're done. Okay, so it seems like most folks have their hands up. Can everyone lower their hands? I'm learning. And next up, can I get a volunteer to read it's two pager, this Frank O'Hara poem, which, heads up, has a tiny bit of French in it. I'm not here to police anyone's anything. I would read it myself, except I don't speak French. But I love this poem very much. All right, hold on. Can Sarah read?
It is 12:10 in New York, and I'm wondering if I will finish this in time to meet Norman for lunch. Ah, lunch. I think I'm going crazy. What with my terrible hangover and the weekend coming up at excitement-prone Kenneth Cope. I wish I were staying in town and working on my poems at Jones Studio for a new book by Grove Press, which they will probably not print. But it is good to be several floors up in the dead of night, wondering whether you are any good or not. And the only decision you can make is that you did it. Yesterday, I looked up the Rue Fremcourt on a map and was happy to find it like a bird flying over Paris at Cesse and Vience, which unfortunately did not include Sienne et Oise, which I don't know, as well as a number of other things. And Alan is back talking about God a lot. And Peter is back not talking very much. And Joe has a cold and is not coming to Kenneth's, although he is coming to lunch with Norman. I suspect he is making a distinction. Well, who isn't? I wish I were reeling around Paris instead of reeling around New York. I wish I weren't reeling at all. It is spring. The ice has melted. The Ricard is being poured. We are all happy and young and toothless. It is the same old age. The only thing to do is simply continue. Is that simple? Yes, it is simple because it is the only thing to do. Can you do it? Yes, you can because it is the only thing to do. Blue light over the Bois de Boulogne. It continues. The Seine continues. The Louvre stays open, it continues. It hardly closes at all. The Bar American continues to be French. De Gaulle continues to be Algerian, as does Camus. Shirley Goldfarb continues to be Shirley Goldfarb. And Jane Hazan continues to be Jane Frailcher, I think. And Irving Sandler continues to be the balayeur d'artistes, and so do I. Sometimes I think I'm in love with painting, and surely the Piscine de Ligne continues to have water in it, and the floor continues to have tables and newspapers and people under them. And surely we shall not continue to be unhappy. We shall be happy, but we shall continue to be ourselves. Everything continues to be possible. René Char, Pierre Reverdy, Samuel Beckett, it is possible, isn't it? I love Reverdy for saying yes, though I don't believe it.
Thank you so much. Hold on, switch back to one page. What do you miss most when you miss your friends? I want you to list three of those, I'm sure, thousands and thousands of things. Three things you miss the most when you miss your friends. And then you already know how it goes. When you're done, raise your hand. Not like to the camera, but in the little participants box. Why is it doing that? Okay, it looks like most of y'all have your hands up. Next, hold on, let me pull this up. This is, I had to put this in columns because it's a little longer. Can I get a volunteer to read My Nig by Danez Smith? But as you volunteer, make sure you're allowed to say My Nig. So, let's see. Can I get Miriam to unmute yourself and read, please?
My Nig. Can y'all hear me?
Yes.
All right. This one isn't about language, but who the language holds. Those niggas who say my name like it's good news. Those who let me know my blood is speckled sapphire. I'm in love with purple gums, the yellow stains of front teeth, the bit of plaque unbrushed and revealed when my niggas laugh, oh loves. I know God is for I have seen you thrown your cackle in the air and watched the clouds turn heavy bronze. I have seen tears well in the corners of your eyes when you are overcome with joy and the little wet is all the sea I need to live. We are alive and amen. Someone of us are dead, but they are alive in us, amen. Heaven be your blunted breath, your chapped lips and sharp shade, your ashy elbows and lotion prayers. I need no church but my niggas' arms. I need no savior but their love. Oh, sweet God, if you be my nigga, don't ever take my niggas from me, lest I be black and yokeless and yokeless shell. Lest I be tabernacle at the bottom of the sea. Lest I be whittled down to not a nigga, but an N-word. One letter to say a thing about shame. Keep me free from that kind of hell. Let me live forever on tongues on my people. And when they gone from this world, then I have use for me. Let me end when they end. Let my breath jump off the cliff with them all. They be my follower. I'm so sorry. They be a follower into that greater world where streets are paved with our enemies' teeth and the angels sing of shine where the rivers flow milk and honey and Hennessy and Kool-Aid and none of that. And just give me the heaven of now, give me days near water with my niggas. Leave me be in the sun, surrounded by my friends, good, black as well, get blacker. We caramelize children of the darker God, of a darker God. We summer kin, August colored, my brick colored friends, the safety that is they being, the peace I feel when near their hands. Hosanna, the bridge over crossfire. They be when they press green in paper and seal their lips. This piff kiss, Hosanna, the rope that a text message be for those who, for who knows how many times I was saved by the ding of, hey, how are you? Or what you on, ho? Bless the grace of being bored with the fam, the heaven of my niggas, in silent room, the holy of the quiet which saves me in the darkest hours. The only thing that kept the blade from my wrist, closed the medicine cabinet, was the thought of my friends in a room dressed in black. That is not their skin. How could he do that to them? How could I deny us the grace of accidents and old age, the laws of disease and holy sick? There is already so much trying to end us, so let it not include our hands today. Let us know be dead and red-handed for it. Not today, not ever, not yet.
Thank you. Let me bring this back to one page. Okay. What are your prayers for your people, your friends, your homies, your communities? List three of those prayers. And when you're done, if you could, well, if everyone could lower their hands first, and then when you're done, raise your hand. Okay, so it seems like most people's hands are up. Also, once again, these are just, you're just making notes for yourself to maybe use or not use ultimately in the poem. Also, thank you to everyone who read to us so beautifully. Now we have the prompt. I promise I didn't just bring you here to like read poems to me and make lists. So the prompt, which is super, super open-ended, and I hope you feel liberated by that. I want you to think about your people, a friend or a group of friends or a community or a group chat or your book club or your quilting circle, whatever you think of when you think my people. And I want you to write this to them and for them. I want you to make fun of them, celebrate them, protect them, defend them, serenade them, miss them, make plans with them, quote them. Whatever it is, I want you to make this poem as an offering to them, whatever that entails, whatever your particular love languages are with that group of people. We're gonna take about 20 minutes to write. I'll check in with you at the end of those 20 minutes to see if you need more time. If there's any poem from what we've looked at that you want to get a second look at, if you want me to pull it back up on the screen, just put it in the chat box and I will let you know. I'm gonna, in the meantime, play a little writing music, which I hope everyone will be able to hear, but give me a second. Let's bring up the Ross Gay poem, and then I'll type out the titles.
Pray that my hope can stay. Find ourselves away from our world, state of mind. It's all in us, it's all in us. Afraid of time, they try to sever. Don't remind, there's always more to fall. Can't be blind, cause it is bright. And this ain't right or wrong. So I hung on, so I hung on. We walk alone, we try to build. Too many things in a long way. Too much of cold in a warm, warm place. So I hung on, so I hung on. We act like fools, same place. Do anything in a long, long way. Too much of cold in a warm, warm place. It's all in we rise. It's been a hard, hard time for the ones who fight in the land of the now. You might have heard. We must have learned it's a faded song. Happened times before. Real after being touched, this need for justice. Standing up so we can trust should have been bloodless. Too many lives to be silenced. Hope it's a fight and to make sure that doesn't pass by. Cause we got the right.
So if there's another poem you want me to pull up, let me know. Otherwise, I'm going to go back to the prompt page so people can have that to look at.
We are cologne. We try to play. Do anything, it's a long, long way. Too much of cold in one more place. So I know. So I have heard. We act like fools. Same place, do anything in a long. much a cold and a warm will place. There's a dream tower. These thieves, they don't feel get away. That's a sweet dream where those who ain't had a chance prosper. Old total hold back, face on, take on the ways long, and we come home, chain strong, find out there's more to hope. Sabah al-khair. We act like fools and we stay in place. Too much for some, got a long way. Too much for cold and a warm place.
We have يا غايب لي ما تسأل أحبابك اللي حكونك ناموا لي لعيونك أنا بفكر فيك تبعد عني تنساني تاجك شمبي تدعاني سيني جروحي وحزاني أنا مشتاق لعلي يا حبيبي لتروحي بعيد انت نصيبي وقلبي وحيد انت اللي في قلبي والله انت اللي في قلبي يا 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 I'll say that you're bad don't see it in a tunnel جايك ما كانت تورن ضو ik geef niet op ik geef niet op aan onze liefde dit is love dit is love يا حبيبي لتروحي بعيد انت نصيبي وقلبي وحيد انت اللي في قلبي والله انت اللي في قلبي يا 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 يا
أم
And you've got about 5 minutes or so left to write. Does anyone need more time?
Thank you.
Okay, do folks need more time? Take like the next couple seconds to finish spelling the word you're spelling. And then here's what I was hoping we could do. I really wanna know what y'all wrote, but I understand there's a billion of us in here and also it's Zoom. But if you feel comfortable, I would love it if you could share all of what you wrote, part of what you wrote, a line, an image, the whole poem, the first stanza, you know, whatever you feel comfortable sharing. So I'm gonna do kind of an experiment in self-government where I'm not gonna call on anyone. Whoever wants to read can unmute and start reading. If it happens to be at the same time as another person, you have to figure it out. And I think we'll be okay. I'm gonna stop screen sharing for a second so I could see everyone. All right, would someone like to go first?